Hello everyone, and welcome to the Animal Crossing New Horizons popularity, the September Hunger Games. And also, it's the 21st of September, so let's go! So anyways, this is the roster. Pretty much the cast hasn't really gotten old. But Pungy is returning, in fact. So, without further ado, you guys already know what's the rules for this game. So, let the games begin! So, as the tributes stand on their podiums, the horn sounds. Lucky takes a spear from inside the cornucopia. Raven rips a mace out of Fuchsia's hands. Sherba grabs a shield leaning on the cornucopia. Shino finds a bag full of explosives. Ketchup finds a bow, some arrows, and a quiver. Kid Kat runs away with a lighter and some rope. Fauna snatches a bottle of, fruit juice and a rag. Yeah, I'm not saying this word because, you know, I'm replacing it with Animal Crossing friendliness. Rold also rips a mace out of Marina's hands. Or tentacles, whatever you want to call them. Zucker and Audie fight for a bag. Zucker gives up and retreats. Unka breaks Ione's nose for a basket of bread. Dang, we're going crazy already! Maple, Coco, and Lolly work together to get as many supplies as possible. The normal villagers are working together! Let's go! Molly runs away from the cornucopia. Marshall grabs a backpack and retreats. Punchy and Bob fight for a bag. Punchy gives up and retreats. Dang, the two lazy cat villagers are going at it. Sasha runs away from the cornucopia. Judy snatches a bottle of fruit juice and a rag. And Stitches steps off the podium too soon and blows up. Okay, one death already, and that's Stitches. Yeah, poor Stitches. He does not deserve this death already. Okay. Audie is picked by thorns while picking berries. Marina thinks about home. Unka explores the arena. Zucker sprains his ankle while running away from Ketchup. Must be his tentacle. I don't know at this point. Coco stalks Kid Kat. Lucky's pricked by thorns while picking berries as well. Shino, Maple, and Judy hunt for other tributes. Bob runs away from Marshall. Rold chases Punchy. Molly and Raymond work together for the day. Sasha fishes. Fuchsia searches for firewood. Sher receives medical supplies from an unknown sponsor. Fauna hunts for other tributes. And Ione and Lolly work together for a day. One cannon shot can be heard in the distance, and that's Stitches. Here we go. Night one. Fuchsia receives clean water from an unknown sponsor. Okay. Hang on. Okay. Maple tends to Coco's wounds. Marina climbs a tree to rest. Unga shoots an arrow at Molly, but misses and kills Ketchup instead. Wow, Ketchup's dead already, too. Punchy and Raymond huddle for warmth. Two cats huddle in for warmth. Let's go. Shino tends to Sherb's wounds. Fauna is unable to start a fire and sleeps without warmth. Ione lets Marshall into her shelter. Dang, the squirrels are also doing the same. Audie sets up camp for the night. Kit Kat lets Lolly into his shelter. What is with the same species, like, you know, hanging out together? Lucky convinces Roll to snuggle with him. Zucker looks at the night sky. Sasha attempts to start a fire, but is unsuccessful. Fauna, you should have gone to Sasha's fire! Judy cooks her food before putting her fire out. Bob receives clean water from an unknown sponsor. And that's it for night one. No one has died tonight. Day two. Here we go. Roldan and Ione hunt for the tributes. Mabel stalks Shino. Raymond tries to spearfish with a trident. Judy injures herself. Fauna, Bob, Sasha, Fuchsia, and Marshall hunt for other tributes. Marina receives a hatchet from an unknown sponsor. Coco kills Lucky with a sickle. Rip, Lucky. Kid Kat decapitates Audie with a sword. Okay, straight off the bat, a lot of villagers are dying. Punchy sprains his ankle while running away from Anka. Okay, two villagers have died so far. Zucker makes a slingshot. Molly searches for firewood. Lolly sees smoke rising in the distance but decides not to investigate. And Sherb also sees smoke rising in the distance but decides not to investigate. Three cannon shots catch up Lucky and Audie. Oh my goodness gracious! Raymond severely injures Marina but puts her out of her misery. Rip. Fuchsia sees a fire but stays hidden. Sasha, Punchy, and Shino sleep in shifts. Zucker screams for help. He must have saw Raymond kill Marina and he's screaming, "Help! Marina's gotten severely injured! And I think she's dying! Someone help!" Fauna is awoken by nightmares. Anka tends to Lolly's wounds. Ione is unable to start a fire and sleeps without warmth. Bob, Sherb, Maple, Judy, and Rold sleep in shifts. Coco, Kid Kat, and Marshall get into a fight. Coco triumphantly kills them both. Dang, Coco is out for blood. She has killed, the Lucky. Now she's killed Marshall and Kid Kat. Dang. And Molly receives medical supplies from an unknown sponsor. Fauna picks flowers. Zucker overhears Shino and Sasha talking in the distance. Fuchsia questions their sanity. Molly, Judy, and Sherb hunt for their tributes. Bob makes a slingshot. Roald discovers a river. Mabel begs Coco to kill her. She refuses, keeping Mabel alive. Girl, you literally just murdered three villagers earlier. What the heck, Mabel? Lolly scares Raymond off. Dang, cat scaring cat. Cat scaring cat. Ione stonks Anka. Punchy discovers a river. And that's it. Three cannon shots can be heard in the distance. Marina, Kid Kat, and Marshall. Speaking of which, with Marshall gone, that means the number one villager for this month is gone. Okay, here we go. Night 3. Fuchsia quietly hums. Raymond looks at the night sky. Sherb starts a fire. Anka thinks about winning. Well, you should. I mean, Anka, your birthday is tomorrow, in fact. So hopefully she wins. Bob stays awake all night. He's pulling an all-nighter, y'all! Punchy questions his sanity. Zucker, Maple, and Ione sleep in shifts. Molly sets up camp for the night. Judy, Fauna, and Roald discuss the games and what might happen in the morning. And Coco tries to treat her infection. And Sasha also stays awake all night. So straight off the bat, two villagers that are pulling all-nighters. And Shino tends to Lolly's wounds. Maple kills Fauna while she is resting. Wow, rip Fauna. Rip. Ione tries to spear fish with a trident. Shino searches for a water source. Anka begs Molly to kill her. She refuses, keeping Anka alive. Okay. Sasha, Sherb, Bob, and Fuchsia hunt for other tributes. Coco fishes. Judy begs Zucker to kill her. He refuses, keeping Judy alive. Raymond questions his sanity. Lolly receives a hatchet from an unknown sponsor. Roald practices archery. Punchy unknowingly eats toxic berries, and therefore Punchy is gone. Rip. And only two villagers have died, Fauna and Punchy. Okay. Roald stays awake all night. another all-nighter here. Zucker fends Sasha and Molly away from his fire. Lolly screams for help. Maple and Bob run into each other and decide to truce for the night. Coco tries to sing herself to sleep. Raymond tries to treat his infection. Sherb tends to his wounds. Judy looks at the night sky. Ione attempts to start a fire but is unsuccessful. Unka also screams for help. And Fuchsia is awoken by nightmares. Here we go. Unka receives fresh food from an unknown sponsor. Raymond lets Ione into... Raymond tends to Ione's wounds. That's what I meant. Zucker attacks Molly, but she manages to escape. Coco chases Roald. Sasha runs away from Judy. Lolly chases Bob. Sherb scares Shino off. Fuchsia receives a hatchet from an unknown sponsor. Maple hunts for other tributes. And no villagers have died tonight. Let's go! Bob, Fuchsia, and Maple discuss the games and what might happen in the morning. Unka tries to sing herself to sleep. Sherb and Judy run into each other and decide to truce for the night. Zucker, Ione, and Coco discuss the games and what might happen in the morning. Yeah. Why are you two, hanging around Coco? She literally murdered three villagers, and so maybe she might betray you two. Molly, Lolly, why is it those two? Again, their names sound so similar. And Raymond sleep in shifts. Sasha is unable to start a fire and sleeps without warmth. Shino climbs a tree to rest. Roald cries himself to sleep. And no one has died. Fuchsia runs away from Lolly. Zucker picks flowers. Sasha defeats Raymond in a fight but spares his life. Maple goes hunting. Shino overhears Unka and Bob talking in the distance. Judy runs away from Sherb. Roald stalks Coco. Molly discovers a river. And Ione hunts for other tributes. No cannon shots. No villagers are dying. Let's go. Unka convinces Sherb to snuggle with her. Coco and Judy sleep in shifts as well as Lolly and Zucker. And same with Raymond and Bob. Roald goes to sleep. Maple thinks about home. Shino poisons Fuchsia's drink but mistakes it for her own and dies. Well, there goes Shino. Rip. Sasha begs Ione to kill him. She refuses, keeping Sasha alive. Hey, let's go! Ione's sparing Sasha's life. Molly looks at the night sky. Unka camouflages herself in the bushes. Roald and Sasha work together for the day. Raymond makes another slingshot. Is this the second slingshot he's made? I don't know. Maple scares Molly off. So as Bob with Zucker. Lolly receives a hatchet from an unknown sponsor. Coco discovers a river. Sherb explores the arena. Ione also explores the arena. And Judy steals from Fuchsia while she isn't looking. So sadly, Shino is gone. So we're going to look at everyone's status here. So the only villagers remaining are Raymond, Bob, Molly, Zucker, Sherb, Unka, Lolly, Maple, Fuchsia, Sasha, Judy, Coco, and Ione. That's all who's left in the game. So let's see what happens. Zucker is awoken by nightmares. Ione sets up camp for the night. Fuchsia sets Unka on fire with a Molotov? Dang. Fuchsia. It's literally setting Unka on fire. When it's literally her birthday tomorrow, so rip. Unka does not deserve a fiery death. Molly passes out from exhaustion. Judy, Sasha, Lolly, Maple, and Sherb sleep in shifts. Roald and Bob tell stories about themselves to each other. Coco and Raymond sleep in shifts. Raymond, I believe Coco might betray you, so you better stay away from her. She is out for blood. Molly and Bob split up to search for resources. Judy thinks about home. Fuchsia searches for firewood. Sasha searches for a water source. Maple begs Sherb to kill her. He refuses, keeping Maple alive. Is this the second time that Maple's asked someone to kill her? Raymond fishes. Lolly's pricked by thorns while picking berries. Ione thinks about home. Roald explores the arena. Coco hunts for other tributes. And Zucker receives fresh food from an unknown sponsor. Anka is the only villager that has died. And night number 8. Zucker and Coco hold hands. Well, Zucker has tentacles, so yeah, I don't think Zucker really has hands. Sherb starts a fire. Maple goes to sleep. Roald tries to treat his infection. Fuchsia cooks her food before putting her fire out. Lolly and Molly talk about the other tributes still alive. Bob thinks about winning. Raymond and Judy are also talking about the tributes that are still alive. And Ione strangles Sasha after engaging in a fist fight. Well, there goes Sasha. And I think this is... When is the feast gonna happen? I'm pretty confused. I mean, Sasha's died, so maybe at least one more villager has to die. Okay, Lolly sees smoke rising in the distance but decides not to investigate. Molly collects fruit from a tree. Judy scares Roald off. Ione diverts Coco's attention and runs away. Fuchsia, Zucker, and Raymond get into a fight. Raymond triumphantly kills them both. Well, there goes Fuchsia and Zucker. They were both doing pretty good. Maple constructs a shack. And Sherb sees smoke rising in the distance, but decides not to investigate. Dude, you literally made a fire yesterday! Evening, like, why are you, like, you know, not investigating? And Bob receives an explosive from an unknown sponsor. 3 cannon shots, Sasha, Fuchsia, and Zucker. Sherb is unable to start a fire and sleeps without warmth. Coco kills a lot. Wrong villager. Lolly kills Coco for her supplies. Well, Lolly just murdered our psychopath here. So let's go, Lolly! Roald fends Raymond, Maple, and Bob away from his fire. Ione receives an explosive from an unknown sponsor. And Molly receives clean water from an unknown sponsor. And Judy is unable to start a fire and sleeps without warmth as well. And here we are, we're going to the feast. Sherb overpowers Raymond, killing him. Molly, Ione, and Roald get into a fight. Molly triumphantly kills them both. Bob and Judy decide to work together to get more supplies. And Lolly decides not to go to the feast. Maple gathers as much food as she can before fleeing. Smart move there, Maple. Smart move. Lolly travels to higher ground. Bob, Judy, and Sherb hunt for their tributes. Maple collects fruit from a tree. And Molly dies from thirst. This is probably the most deaths we got. 5 villagers have died. Coco, Raymond, Ione, Sherb... Oh, wrong villager. Roald and Molly. Sherb is still in the game. Maple is awoken by nightmares. Lolly receives a hatchet from an unknown sponsor. Bob is also awoken by nightmares, and Sherb and Judy run into each other and decide to truce for the night. Judy attacks Lolly, but she manages to escape. Maple tends to Sherb's wounds. Bob is picked by thorns while picking berries. No villagers have died. Maple receives a hatchet from an unknown sponsor. Bob accidentally detonates a landmine while trying to arm it, and therefore Bob is gone. Judy tries to treat her infection, and Sherb and Lolly sleep in shifts. Judy receives clean water from an unknown sponsor. Lolly receives fresh food from an unknown sponsor. Sherb travels to higher ground, and Maple camouflages herself in the bushes. Bob is the only villager that has died tonight. Maple receives an explosive from an unknown sponsor. Sherb receives medical supplies from an unknown sponsor. Judy goes to sleep. Lolly attempts to start a fire but is unsuccessful. Maple, Sherb, and Lolly hunt for their tributes, and Judy receives fresh food from an unknown sponsor. No villagers have died. Sherb thinks about home. Judy sets up camp for the night. Lolly cooks her food before putting her fire out, and Maple sees a fire but stays hidden. She must have seen the fire that Lolly did, but that was before she put her fire out, I think. Maple questions her sanity. Sherb chases Judy, and Lolly dies from an infection. Wow, I'm surprised that Sherb has gotten this far in the game. I don't know what I'm gonna do if he wins again. I mean, he's won. Did he win Survivor? I think so. So Lolly has died. Judy and Maple talk about the tribute still alive. Sherb looks at the night sky. Judy receives clean water from an unknown sponsor, and Sherb defeats Maple in a fight, but spares her life. No villagers have died. Well, it's up to Sherb, Judy, and Maple. One of them is going to win. Who will win? Who will win? Let's see. Okay, Sherb destroys Judy's supplies while she is asleep, and Maple receives fresh food from an unknown sponsor. Judy tries to spear Fish with a trident. Sherb attacks Maple, but she manages to escape. And let's see. Maple destroys Sherb's supplies while she is asleep, and... I'm wrong. Oops. Okay. Maple destroys Sherb's supplies while he is asleep. Sorry about that. I can't believe I did that. Judy attempts to start a fire, but is unsuccessful. Judy and Maple hunt for their tributes, and Sherb constructs a shack. How are they surviving? How are they doing so good? Like, one of them should die or something. Oh, Sherb quietly hums. Maple unknowingly eats toxic berries. And Judy cannot handle the circumstances and unlives herself. Yep, I am not saying this word as well. I'm going to get demonetized. So, Sherb has won again. So, hey, let's go. Sherb is the winner again. So, this is the final results. I'm kind of getting excited because we're almost at the end of the year. And, you know, Sherb has won and... You know, he won Survivor last month. Don't worry, I'm still doing that. Probably next week. I'm thinking about... It might come out next Sunday, which will be on Marshall's birthday. So, hey, let's go! So, that is it for this video. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys!